What is good, Mexiplanners? Today we're going to be talking about how to find a nanny when moving to Merida, Mexico. Stay tuned. One of the cool things about living in Merida, Mexico is that you're able to live at a higher quality of life. Like we live really well in Atlanta where we're from, but to be able to move here meant we were able to have help, have services, have things that we, you know, were just, it would have been extraordinarily expensive to do in the United States. Let me explain. One of the things that we were able to do, because we are parents of a young child, we were able to hire a nanny when moving here to Merida, Mexico. What that's allowed us to do is just really, our youngest child is not an only child. She has someone that can keep her entertained, that can play with her, but also help her to grow by learning Spanish and other things. So it's allowed us to be able to also be able to be free so I can do things like make these videos for you, then my wife can run her club that she has called Club Wonder Garden for kids on Tuesdays and Thursdays here in Merida, Mexico, and many other things. So it's allowed us to go on date nights. It's allowed us to have freedom and just to be able to go out and, you know, run errands when we needed to, which has been really incredible, just to have another set of eyes and a caring heart to look after our most precious gift, which is our baby. It's been a really awesome experience having this extra set of hands to just give us a lift and really make this experience of living in Mexico that much more enriching. We've had a couple of different nannies since coming here to Merida, Mexico. Our second nanny was a live-in nanny who lived in a little town about an hour and 15 minutes away from Merida, Mexico. Now the challenge with that is that we would have to drive in one direction, an hour 15 minutes, pick her up, bring her back to our house, where she would then work for, you know, 10 or 11 days, and then we would drive her back to her small town. The biggest issue with that was, A, she was away from town, she didn't know anybody, she's here with us, and we really believe she became homesick. So after about a month of going back and forth every few weeks, it was only, you know, four times that we had to drive there and back, she became homesick and was unable to come and work with us anymore. That was, you know, our first experience with having a great nanny and then losing that person because of extenuating circumstances. So our third nanny was perfect, or so it seemed. She was an Afro-Latino student who was finishing up college, and really the only thing she had to do was to write a paper to, I guess, support her collegiate studies. Now, the challenge that we had was when we hired her, we went and met her mom. We talked to her mom. She started the same day, and she worked for us the rest of that day just to kind of get a feel for her and for her to get a feel for us. The next day we picked her up, things seemed okay. She was excited. She worked a full day that day. And then on the third day we went to pick her up, and she was like, "Hey, my dad said I need to stop working because I need to focus on finishing school." Now, I get it, right? I'm a dad, I understand. I wasn't gonna try to talk to her pops, but in fact, I just told my daughter that she didn't need to worry about getting a job, she needed to focus on school, right? And so I absolutely get it. But the disappointment was, you know, this is a person who immigrated to Mexico from the Dominican Republic. It was someone that my daughter could look up to because she's been, you know, she's had that experience of being four and then now being 20 something and growing up here in Mexico as an Afro-Latino. So we were really disappointed that we, you know, couldn't further that relationship, but it happens. Blessing in all of this was our fourth nanny, which is who we have now. So our new nanny is a live-in, and if you want to know how we found her, check out the Mexpat Experience above. That is my wife's channel. She has a video on how to find nannies and all the different rates and et cetera of what it costs to have a nanny here in Merida, Mexico. Check that out. But the lesson I learned from the third nanny, which was the Afro-Latino lady, was that you gotta talk to the pops. If it is a Latino woman and she is living in the house of dad, dad calls the shots, right? That's just how it is here. And so you just have to know, like, you can't just talk to mom, you got to also talk to dad. because that's who ultimately makes the decisions on whether or not she can work or not work or what have you. How do you feel about, you know, that whole dynamic of the father's the head of the household here and they make the decisions for these young adults? I mean, these ladies were in their 20s. So tell me how you feel about this dynamic here in Latin America. It is definitely something that is a part of the culture, but I want to give you just a little bit of tips on, you know, from a dad's perspective is you got to check with the father here in Latin America and to make sure things are good. And I feel like really we ran into that scenario in two different instances, one with our nanny who lived way out in the village, and then the other one who was local, but was finishing up school and pops was like, yeah, you got to stop that. So anyway, make sure, you know, these are our tips. This is my tip from a dad's perspective on how to be successful in finding a nanny here in Merida, Mexico. Guys, thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate your time and attention. If you like this information, let me know. If you don't like this information, let me know. Please do me a favor. If this video has added any value to you, click the thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and ring that bell. If you ring that bell, it'll tell you every time we post a new video. Thanks again, guys. This is Mexit Plan Monty. I'm out.